one of the paramount things, I'm reminded of Richard Crenna from First Blood. Anyway, the thing back there was if they were in doubt, kill. That was the thing. When in doubt in your training and you're fighting somebody, don't worry about the techniques, don't worry about anything else. The first is establish that base, establish mobility, establish an understanding of your exits. Always remember, if you are in doubt about what you could do in any particular location or time, hit. Always offend the face, the senses, the throat, hit at every opportunity. So some of your training will be geared to one person controlling and holding, and out of here she's got to find a way to hit me. So there's no need, the base training that we do should be already ingrained. So I'll be testing her base, I'll be holding down her hands, she's got to find a way to hit. So she's going to go on the inside like that. So during your training it'll be like open palm, you just kind of tap the face, you get that in there. If she wants to clear this, she can clear that either that way, or she'll hit down as she pulls that up. So one of the things that makes that more efficient is when she actually breaks this down, she's going to have a punch on the way as she's doing it. That makes it more efficient. So bam. So that's some of the Rebel Wing Chun influence. My hands, especially in that position, if she hits it, we're going to go slow here. So she's going to hit at a slight downward angle there as her fist comes in the other direction, and she's going to time those fairly well. They work well together. Do it. There you go. So that in under stress, bam, breaks, works really well. Remember to break it there. If the person has it here and you hit just right, you'll feel that nerve shoot down to here because you've got the medial nerve that goes down and you're gonna pop those. So you get that if you're doing it well. Remember, it's those opposing shearing forces that are combined in one movement that help. So now we're struggling, we've gotten whatever else, we're in here, I've got start of a bind. What is she going to do to hit? One is, bam, right there, it's already there, is the headbutt. That should always be there. But we're focusing on the hands, how can she get the hands there? So she'll clear that. She can come around this side like that and come up underneath, which would be sneaky. Because if I'm trying to set her up in a throw though, she might not be able to get that hand in there. So there, that's the simplest thing, is just to hit my face. She'll do an open palm on the inside, bam, like that. And even if she's bringing it like back from here, crack, and putting my head into her headbutt, that is, you go towards the thumb, curl it up, and extend it out and bring it in. So now even if she wasn't using the headbutt, let's say my shoulder's in the way. So she's gonna curl that out towards my thumb in a short, sharp movement. And if she does it where her palm is up, so you can go right to the strike. So look for those efficiencies. It really matters, this tenth of a second that it takes to go from this position is a tenth of a second that I could have had to strike. So when this is coming out like that, she's already open into the palm strike. So always look and avail yourselves to the most efficient way to access the strike. That means I'm going from point A to point B with the least amount of movement possible in the shortest range possible, the straightest line usually. So we're in some other position. I'm in here like this, I'm controlling her, I've got this. Now she's in here and I'm a little tighter. So there is one that comes right up underneath. A lot of people don't do this. They're usually like this and they'll have their head forward and things like that. So that makes it really well. For us people who are trained a little bit, I may be trying to hip in and trying to offset her base while pulling her and changing her base. So she may have to step out a little bit as she tries to put that in play. But when you're working this, just do palm strikes, nice little taps. Get used to that, regardless of where you are. If you are in doubt, hit. If you are in doubt, hit. If you are in doubt, upside down, hit. If you're in doubt, wrapped up in cellophane, hit. If you can get the hand out, you have to discover where to get the hand out. If you're a hammer, then everything else is a nail. You have to look toward that mentality. If I want to hit, there's a good story that I had. One martial artist from another martial artist friend of mine took an art that wasn't known for boxing. All he wanted to do, because he couldn't kick, it was a martial art that was kicking, but he didn't have the greatest kicking. So whenever he would spar, his mentality was, no matter what, I am going to punch them in the nose. That was it. And you know what? Every single time in sparring, he punched them in the nose, because that was his driving thought. And it worked every time, because he made every motion, every opportunity to find out, how can I punch him in the nose? That's what you have to do. You have to look and seek for that opportunity. No matter where I am, I'm going to hit the face, hit that, disturb it, so that opens up opportunities for you. If you think your art is the best art in the world, then you're focusing on the wrong thing. The art isn't the thing, it's the creating human being that is the thing. It's being able to take these problems and find a solution for it, regardless of where it came from, because nobody owns the movement from here to here. You can't say you own that. This is no other human can do this. I got the patent on that. So when you're sitting there and you've got this mentality, oh, this is only this is only that, that's why you'll never understand and you'll never see a JKD person, because they are the style without style. They are the people who will do things from one range to the next seamlessly. There is going to be no thought. It is an instant reaction, and it doesn't stop. You could put them on the ground and they'll flow. You can put them in clinch range, they'll flow. You put them in boxing, kicking, with a knife, with a bat, with a rope, with a squirrel, okay? They will utilize whatever is possible to solve a problem that they're in, to survive. It just so happens to survive in this case, but this creative engine goes into so many other areas. Just to let you know, that's the true JKD artist, is they are not seen. Somebody on the outside will say, oh, well, that was Muay Thai. Well, no, maybe that was Jiu-Jitsu. Well, no, this was, then they'll go on and they'll list only by their experience. And they don't understand that this creating individual is modifying this on the fly based on the stimulus that's coming to their senses. And then they're allowing the freedom of their creativity to blast themselves to express their JKD as it was meant.